How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. Continuing with the Hemingway Kits. And we're up to the point here, we made the body right here. Now there's some milling that needs to be done. There's a flat and a flat 180 degrees apart on the outside of the body. There's two holes that need to be drilled. That's a slight key, and that slight key raised portion will fit in here to make that mate together. That's what that's for. But also, these end up being at an angle across that surface. Let's go back to a little more work on this body.
You need to take off a half a millimeter in depth flat spot, so that's about 20 thousandths. This is just an approximate type thing, just as long as they're close to being the same. At least that's what they say. So we'll take off 20 thousandths off each side 180 degrees apart. We're all ready to drill the hole. We're gonna just do the spot drill. This is just an access hole for the set screw in the spindle. We need to place this part. So they call this end the front, this end the back. We need to place this part in the vise at 1 degree angle. So that's tilted like that, right? 1 degree. Well, they put 0.45 millimeters of shim under one edge, put it down in the vise, and tilt it up. Well, I have made these little blocks. Well, a couple of years ago, these are stainless, and I precision angled those. So this is 1 degree, and that's what the angle they want. So all I gotta do is put it in there, set it on that block, and tighten the vise on the two flats, and I'm good to go. 1 degree. Now we have to find the center of the bore, and remember it's 1 degree angle, so really it's not a round hole, it's kind of an elliptical because of the angle. I used a dial test indicator and just swept until I got it in the middle. Now they recommend you use a coaxial indicator, but I don't have a coaxial indicator, so it maybe took me a couple extra minutes to do this, but not too bad. We're going to make a matching tab or raised key, whatever you want to call it, in this surface so it matches the shank groove here. That shank groove is 25 thousandths, so we'll make it only 20 thousandths tall, and it's 158 thousandths wide. So we're going to make it a little bit wider and then sneak up on it to get it to finish width. We're only going to go down 20 thousandths on each side here. Yeah, that looks fairly wide. Probably like 20 thousandths wide, it looks like. Yep.
a little more. We'll just keep going back and forth a little bit at a time till we get her dialed in. All right, I think we got a nice fit there. You can see the alignment. There's our tab. There's our groove. And I think we got a really pretty good fit, huh? There's zero play. Zero play. So, that's nice. Next thing, we just got to drill our holes. Then we have to turn an outside bore after that's all to get. I mean, outside diameter, we can match everything up afterwards, I guess. I drilled the, now the holes aren't evenly spaced. One's 352 and the other was 297. And that's because it's off on an angle. So they already calculated out where the holes need to be. So I just went with the drawing, didn't mess with it. And it's bolted on there, so I'm going to take it out. Fit came out really nice on the, where is it? There we go. There's one side, you can see that. Yeah. Then when we do the, now there's enough play in all that, they say that you'll have to do an alignment of it once you get everything ready. There's quite a bit of play there. You can see there's quite a bit of motion there. So hopefully that's enough to get it all aligned. That'll all have to be in the next part. I think the next part is that you gotta make the broaches. So we'll make the broaches and then we'll be able to get it all assembled and get it aligned and all that good stuff. Thanks for watching, you guys, and we'll see you in the next part.